That is working. I hope it's working. I hope you can hear the... Let's see. Right. Okay. I figured we'd kick off Sketch Saturdays with a live drawing. I'm drawing what's underneath for Draw with Jazz's milk competition, and I just figured I'd continue with that. I don't know if you can hear the music in the background. That's by a gentleman called Ross Budgeon. The music is completely royalty free. He has a YouTube channel, which I will link in the description when the broadcast is finished, if you want to go check him out. He does state that we can use his music in his YouTube videos, and it is all royalty free. If you don't believe me, go check out his link. So I figured I'd just sit, draw, and if you enjoy it, give me a thumbs up. If you enjoy it, click subscribe, and we'll see what happens. I'm just going to draw for a bit, and I hope you enjoy. Thanks. I might talk occasionally, but there we go. So, my take on Sketch Saturdays, to give you a brief overview, because you can see I actually started this a while ago, a couple of days ago, last week when he announced it, and I immediately thought of when the competition was released. I immediately thought of War of the Worlds and the Martians and the City Underground and... Well, I can't stand the movie. I really like the music, so we're just going to have a go. That's what I do. So,
hello.
I'm broadcasting. For anyone who isn't familiar, that was my husband just coming in to see what I was up to. Is it working again? So many wires. Might just have to hope the Apple Pencil holds out. I was trying to charge it and thought it isn't going to work. War of the Worlds, Martians. Let's actually get down to some drawing. I don't know about you guys, but I love, absolutely love things like War of the Worlds, sci-fi movies, good ones and the bad ones. My husband loves disaster movies. I would say I share a passion with him on that. A little bit sad, but there's only me watching, but here we go. Hopefully people will see it later and enjoy it. I've got to say, if you are looking for, if you're a more traditional artist, but I'm drawing today using my iPad Pro, Apple Pencil and Procrete, and I'm streaming through Procrete, which is amazing. It really is cool to see that there is that functionality. And for somebody who spent a lot of time drawing as growing up, I love drawing naturally, like pencil and paper, but the ability to change things. I did a lot of black and white drawings when I was younger because I was scared to colour them in case I spoiled it, in case I ruined it. I didn't want that to happen. And you suddenly become very protective, so you don't do a lot. And then I got given the scanner. I scanned things in. I started using a program called PaintShop Pro. I don't know if anybody remembers that. I did a lot of pixel work. Pixel work being, making drawings out of pixels. I got quite good at it. I think there's a website online somewhere where some of my work's still up there. I've forgotten what the Martians look like. Should we make it up? I should make it up. And then I have sketchbooks upon sketchbooks upon sketchbooks. My husband will testify to that, along with folders full of artwork. And when I finished, well, I went to university, I still sketched a bit. And I was still colouring them in on the computer. And then I started working. And as time goes on, life gets hectic, you stop drawing. You pay the bills, which is good. but sometimes creativity goes out of the window. And then 2 years ago, my brother decided he'd had enough and I needed to start drawing again. So he bought me an iPad Pro for Christmas, which was amazing. I cried. And as far as I can tell, now I haven't used any other things. I know that HP have a tablet where you can draw on it using a pencil that's designed and gives you very fine lines. Never used any of those, but as far as I'm concerned, for the Apple, by the way, this isn't sponsored. As far as I could tell, the iPad Pro with the pencil, it's the beautiful combination of both mediums. You can scribble like you're just drawing normally. Talking more than I'm drawing right now, but there we go. So you can scribble, you can draw hard lines, soft lines, faint lines. And then you can add another layer and you can try something out. And then you can colour it in. And if you don't like it, it's on another layer so you can get rid of it and you haven't spoilt the original underneath. And I love that flexibility. I have a Tumblr page, and the condition of me getting that at this iPad was for every single day in January, I would draw a picture. I nearly went crazy. A picture every day is incredibly difficult, as anyone who has done and completed Inktober will tell you. It's hard, it's time consuming. I didn't get much sleep, but I'm so pleased I did it, and I still post up there, not as much as I should, bearing in mind how much I actually do draw using this thing, and I do draw very regularly, at least once, twice, maybe three times a week. So what I'm doing is fleshing out the basics. I realise I haven't actually drawn a lot. All I'm doing right now is the line work, the line art. And we've got the tiny little village up here. There's going to be trees either side. I need something in this area here. That isn't going to help because that is the eraser brush. I need something in this area here. But I have yet to figure out. I had a thought and I didn't. Oh no, it's come back. Mind you, I was going to put the marsh in there. Marsh in here. Yeah, we'll do that. And I have just discovered that in Procrete, bear in mind I've had this program 2 years, if you draw a line and hold your pencil down there, it creates a straight line. And that's not where I wanted it. Which is awesome. And suddenly, your work becomes much more accurate. I'm one of those drawers who likes to be accurate. There we are. And they're called quick lines. There we go. Learn something new every day. Oh, well, that's not what I wanted to do. See, I'm feeling pressure now because people are watching. One person's watching. Hi. I wanted a kind of windmill going on. I am just not having any luck this morning. I might stop talking and just draw. I hope you can hear the music in the background. As I said, it's awesome. I love his music. I think I'm going to be quiet and I'm going to focus on what I'm doing now. sorry about that. I just want you want to hear me sniffing. It's not particularly nice, sorry. video seeing the pipes behind the buildings. Normally I don't do intricate drawings that take forever because I lose interest halfway through, but I'm determined not to this time, so let's keep plugging on. Dinosaur bones? Maybe not. I really don't know what's happened there. Unfortunately, the recording slash streaming stuff on Procrete isn't the most reliable, which is a shame. Oh, where did we get to? Oh yeah, we were drawing an alien. I'm gonna have to see if I can do it some other way, I think. It's getting quite warm. It's probably because it's struggling to do everything that I keep asking it to do. I'm kind of hoping. Finish the sketch underneath the line work and drawing will go a bit quicker. It's all a bit of a jumble, I'm not going to lie. person. And that's about the right size though. So there we go. So my plan is deviate away from this for a little bit. Change up the base to try something. Put it oil paint. That's huge. That's smaller. That's the reason I love traditional techniques in digital media. Because I can make as many mistakes as I like. Just erase it. Look, we have trees. Would like to develop more of in Procrete, the brushes in the it's quite difficult to develop your own or import any in. And that becomes a issue. That was bugging me. I wouldn't see the trees. Don't ask. Also makes me think of Fallout, the bunker, and all of that stuff. Problem is, you wind up drawing very similar things. Everybody's house, while it may look the same, is unique. So I think we'll have houses down this side, and we're gonna have industrial slash shopping down that side. With the housing. I wonder if I can make. Yeah, let's try that down here. those have got squonky. Have those extra large ones at the end.
Same difference.
I interesting when you think about drawing building in four dimensions. I don't know if that's the right. Excavating. You can have any shape you want, really. And it's got nothing to do with gravity. Yeah, I'm not sure where that thought was going. So. Yeah, okay. Fair enough. We're coming along. This is better than it was. So. That's the housing section done. So, yeah. Thank you. industrial. Back again. I honestly don't know what's going on. I just pass. So what I'll probably do is pull all three streams, all three streams off, and then make them into one. And then when we're done, I can upload it all in one go, and people can watch it. It's a bit frustrating, but it is what it is. I might have to find out some way of doing it better next time. So we've moved on to the farming district. Right. These are farms. Farms. Smiley face. Say this does kind of make me think of steampunk stuff. Farm should be underneath, shop and shop should be up front. Farms are vital, shops aren't, but hey. And I need to do pipe work to all of this joy. This is probably the long way round, but never mind. That's coming along nicely. It's certainly a lot further along than it was before. Thank you. Thank you. this will be the last part, to be honest with you. I'm really struggling to get this to last longer than continuous length. So we'll do a little bit more, might finish off the lines, and then I think we'll call it a day for that, and I'll probably go onto my main computer. Oh dear, that's not what I wanted to do. And we will get them all put together and into one video for you all to enjoy. Hopefully, if it wasn't too boring. I think I'll leave it in pretty much its raw state. Just put them all together and you can, if you fancy something to watch in the background or you fancy watching me build it up, you're more than welcome to. So, last little bit to go is this area here. A few more shops, a few more buildings, and we are done for now. Of course, there will be one long overview of the tile apps of the drawing from beginning to end, like I've been doing with the Inktober. I'm a little bit sad I never actually managed to finish Inktober, but the month got a little bit tricky with a holiday in the middle, and I got more done than I thought I was going to do, which is good. So, just to finish off. I've got a lot of the drainage in, and the pipes and the water. It's been a long time since I've done something so intricate. I just hope I can pull this off. Oops. Right, last bit. It's hard to make them different but the same, but yeah. just one more layer and then we're done. I was worried that it stopped recording again. There we go. That's it. That's all the line, all the sketching done. So now I need to put the line work in and the details, but I think we'll leave that there for today because it's been a while. So thank you all for watching with me. It's been a pleasure drawing, listening to music, and I hope whoever's watched or watches in the future has enjoyed it or does enjoy it. So I'll see you all soon. If you fancy something different, I'm bringing out a Minecraft series, hopefully starting on Monday. I play on a server with some of my friends and my husband, and I hope you all enjoy it. So if you liked what you saw, click the like button. If you want to see more, poke the subscribe button, hit the subscribe button. I hope you will keep joining me for more future videos. And I will see you soon. Bye!